Hi friends, I thought it would be so much fun to talk with you guys today about cool toned palettes. I love a good cool toned palette because my skin does not like oranges and the bright, vibrant, like sienna browns, those kinds of things, reds, those kinds of yellows, all that bright stuff. My skin is very cool toned, so I gravitate towards cool tones, and I do have a few of my favorites. So if you're new to my channel, thank you so much for stopping by. I do appreciate that. I hope that you decide to subscribe, ring the bell, please give it a thumbs up, everyone. I am so close to getting 50,000, you guys, and I'm so excited about that. For some reason, right now, all the subscriptions have kind of stalled out, but I'm really looking forward to getting to 50,000, and I have a really good giveaway for you guys when we get there too. I'm going to first talk about my ColourPop palettes and show you those. Now, this one is kind of a no-brainer. Duh, it's cool toned because it is the Blue Moon palette, and blue is cool toned, obviously, but I really have to say that I do adore this palette. I love these three blues right here. This powder blue, this one that is an icy blue. I'll show that to you. It's so pretty. Icy blue on that one. Wow. And then this one right here that is a white with a cast of blue in it. And they're so beautiful, you guys. And I really love this whole entire palette. Now, obviously, I'm not going to wear a complete blue look, but any sort of pop of blue you want to go with a pop of blue on your lids. You want to darken up your eyeshadow with these darker blue colors. But really, ColourPop's formula is so good. The only thing I don't like from ColourPop is when they do those heavy chunky glitters in here. This one doesn't have any of that. It has, I believe this is the Super Shock formula, which I'm absolutely in love with. That's the top one right there. Such a good formula that clings to the eyes. ColourPop shadows are creamy. Their mattes are buildable. Hardly ever anytime do I find anything that is very chalky or kind of patchy or anything. This is a beautiful, beautiful palette. That is the Blue Moon palette. All right, so the next one is In a Trance from ColourPop. Again, I love these colors. These are very pastel cool colors. So you have these very pastel pinks, and you have the pastel purple and the pastel blue. This one over here kind of gives off the blue, purple, all of it together. This is a Super Shock formula when I'm sticking my finger in here. So this is more like a topper when you look at it. And I will go ahead and swatch those for you as well. These colors are beautiful, vibrant, and you're not going to see that Super Shock one because, like I said, it is a topper on there. A little bit of a cast there that you can see as I move my hand. But this one is beautiful if you're very light toned or if you've been looking for some pastel colors, maybe to just go on your lid. Maybe, you know, you're wanting to branch out into some color and you don't really know how to. You don't want to go with those bright, vibrant colors. This In a Trance palette is so pretty. And this is the heavy duty plastic packaging as well. So I like that about it too. And then the next one is All Things Equinox. This is very, very cool toned. Now I will say that the only one in here that I feel like is not super cool toned is this kind of a cocoa brown right here, but it isn't warm at all. I'll show it to you on my finger. It's not a warm color, so you can't really see that. It still has that kind of dusty, muddy quality that you get with a cool tone palette. And when I say that, don't get, you know, like you don't want mud on your face, obviously, but don't get turned off by that because these colors are so pretty and I just love them all. And you're gonna see how very cool toned these are. They are really, really cool toned. Now that one on the bottom is that cocoa one that I just told you about. So it looks a little bit more on the warm side, but it's not. It's a very neutral color. And so I swatched four of those. Beautiful palette if you're looking for something that is along the lines of being, you know, very mauve, but having a little bit brighter than, you know, just your average dusty mauve in there. That one is really pretty. And then the Making Mauves one. Now, this one is a beautiful, beautiful palette. I love this one, you guys, because it does have just all of the cool tone feels in there. This one right here is a Super Shock shadow, gorgeous shadow. I think this one might be super Shock too. So those are two very vibrant chrome colors. Not chrome, that's not a good word. Metallic colors. There's the word I'm trying to pull out of the air. Beautiful on that one. This one is a gorgeous metallic color as well. Buttery, soft, really, really pigmented and just absolutely gorgeous. And I lose my place where I'm trying to swatch to. Really beautiful, beautiful colors right there on the Making Mobs palette. This one is one that if you're thinking, I want to try cool tones, but I don't know if I want to completely dive into the cool tone world, this is really good because you're just like stepping your toe in it. You do have a lot of neutral colors that you can still do a neutral eye with, but you do have a lot of those beautiful shimmers that are going to really give you a cool tone vibe on your eyelids. Really love that one. It's gorgeous. Last one from ColourPop is probably one of my favorites ever. Flutterby by ColourPop. This came out during the holiday season last year. And this is so pretty. I love the packaging on it. We have some embossing on there, which they weren't doing before. It's such a nice packaging. And then you get in here and you get all of these gorgeous, gorgeous colors. This does not have any of the chunky glitter in it, which I really appreciated. And it does have a light color in here. Now this light color is really pretty in that it has a duochrome shift in it, and so it's almost along the lines of a pinky peach in there. It's really beautiful. This one right here though, even though it's not a chunky glitter, it is a glitter, so you are going to get that on there. You just need to use a really good either mixing medium from NYX or their glue. That's it right there. So you are going to get a little bit of fallout from it if you do decide to use it. But these other colors, you guys, they are so gorgeous. It does have a tiny bit of the warm tones, almost neutral tones in here on these two colors over here that are going to warm your look up a little bit. But at the same time, the colors in here are so cool toned and they're so pretty. I'm going to swatch just a couple of these other cool tones so you can see it on there. They're just beautiful. Just a gorgeous, gorgeous palette. I love the presentation of it. I love the product in it for being blendable. I loved that it had so many different colors in here and across the gamut, and you're going to be able to get a lot of looks out of this. It just is really beautiful. One thing I will say that I was talking about at the beginning is that this doesn't have quite enough of the very light transition color in it, even though you can definitely use this color right here. It's really the only color. So if you're wanting to branch out a little bit, you might, but it's such a beautiful palette. This is one of my favorites, and I'm so glad that they kept it around for a long time, because you know ColourPop gets rid of their stuff really quickly, which drives me crazy, but we live with it because we love ColourPop. All right, this one right here is one that I've loved for a long time. This is Milani. This is their old eyeshadow formula. This one is the Soft and Sultry. This is the old 12 pan formula. I wish that they would bring this back. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. They had such beautiful ones, and I actually went out and I got brand new ones because I wanted to make sure I got them all before they all went out of product, well, out of, completely out of stock, because they're never going to bring them back. But this palette is some next level beauty, you guys. All of these are the most creamy, beautiful, blendable colors. I love this palette. I loved everything about it. I love the cool tones in it. I love that it did have a few of the warm tones in it that helped to brighten up your look a little bit, but mostly it just stuck to its name, which is Soft and Sultry, which gives you that look of just having a beautiful smoky eye, and they all work so pretty together. I love this palette. It's one of my very favorites. And like I said, they are all going out of stock. If you guys want to, you can, I think they might still be on the Milani website, but I know that Amazon still has them. But they're starting to raise the prices, because as they do get more rare or you can't find them that much, they raise the prices on them. Everybody does that, which I think is silly. But these are so good, you guys, and I would recommend this over and over again. I'm gonna just really quickly swatch this deep dark that is kind of like a smoky grayish brown. Oh my word, this is so pretty. If you're ever wanting to do some sort of a smoky eye, that is the palette that you need to go to. All right, the next one is the Temptress palette from Alter Ego. This is a dupe for the Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft and Sultry. They did it identically, but actually I think there's some colors in here I like a little bit more than the Soft and Sultry. Now you're gonna look at this and you're gonna see these two colors right here, and they're not cool tones, but everything else in here leans towards being cool. Maybe not this gold one right down here. So I would say out of the 14 shadows, you've got three that are a little bit more along the lines of a warm color. But the reason that I do like that, even though it's not a cool tone, I like that peach in there. I really like it to start out the look as a transition color, and then you have a little bit brighter look to start your cool toned look with, but it really gets toned down with all of these beautiful grays and different colors in here. And man, you guys, I reached for this so many times because This color right here is what makes me retort more than anything. It's that silver metallic that is so pretty. But these are beyond beautiful shadows. They've done such a good job in duping that I really think that they're gonna go places. I know they do Natasha Denona and they do a couple other ones, but I have not had anything but beautiful looks come out of this palette. I have a couple of their other ones that I absolutely love. Huda Beauty's one, it's really good too. But this is probably my favorite that they've ever done. And it's one of my favorite cool tone palettes because it's so neutral that you can really just wear any sort of lip you want to with it. If you wanna, you know, spruce up those eyes and make them look super sultry, or if you want an everyday look, you got it in this palette. And the quality is there. The quality is just stunning on it. And I do have a video on this one where I compared one and then the other, and they're identical on the sultry. But as far as a cool tone palette, you couldn't get anything better than this. Like I said, there are three colors in here that lean towards being warm, but this is so good, you guys, and I would highly recommend that palette. If you're a neutral lover and you're somebody that wants to just bump that neutral look up just a little bit, yeah, it's really beautiful. And then this one I threw in here, this is the Berries palette from Dominique Cosmetics, Berries and Cream, excuse me. I put this one in here because when you first look at it, you can tell that this is a cool tone palette. You have all of these colors that just lean so much towards cool tones. Even though this one is a red, it's kind of a berry red, and so it looks very cool toned. You have this very smoky gray, it's not gray, it's more of a taupe color. You have that bright blue, cobalt blue in there. This is one of my favorite colors ever to put on the eyelid. It is not shimmer, it's just really, really bright that goes on the lid. So pretty. Actually, I'm going to swatch quite a few of these for you, so I will clean my fingers in between. But this is just one of those palettes that I look at, and then I swatch it, and I go, oh my word, those colors are so incredibly beautiful, and they really, truly are. Just, the shimmers are super creamy. They're not chunky. You're not going to look like you have a bunch of texture on your eyelids. The mattes are super duper creamy. They're super blendable, very saturated, very highly pigmented. And the colors in here that she chose are just some next level gorgeousness. You're getting extremely saturated colors in here, but at the same time, you're getting colors that can blend out for you. You're not going to, you know, get them too dark too fast if you just go in with a lighter hand. It is so pretty. It's one of the prettiest palettes. And I think that, I don't remember what year it was, but I awarded this my number one because it is. It's just one of those beautiful, beautiful palettes that makes the most gorgeous looks. And I absolutely love the way that it looks. And she did such a good job. Dominique Cosmetics did such a good job. I have so many of their palettes, but that one truly is my favorite. We're down to the number one. Can you guys guess which one it is? This is a cool tone palette that has so much richness to it and totally stole my heart immediately. And I did a video, seven looks, one palette, with the Sydney Grace Enduring Love. This is quality across the board. The way they packaged it, the actual shadows inside are probably my favorite formula ever. I have tried Viseart. I have seen a Natasha Denona here and there in the little ones and a lot of other ones. I haven't done Pat McGrath yet or Tom Ford, but you guys, honestly, this is probably my favorite formula ever, ever, ever. And the reason that I voted this in as a cool tone palette is because you can't look at this palette and think warm tones unless you're looking at that color right there. But if you took that color out right there, you've got a cool tone palette. But still, this color all by itself is some next level beauty. This one is a little bit on the gold side, but even this one over here that looks really gold, it has that quality of being... it can go either way, I guess is what I'm trying to say. And it does have a little bit of green on its underneath or on its base. And I just think it's so pretty. So I'm gonna swatch quite a few of these for you. There's that one. It does look a little bit gold, but honestly, you guys, it's on the copper peach side. Check out that pewter. Oh my word. And there's that one that I was talking about. It's like a champagne. It's not really gold. So those two colors right there are the only colors in there that you can really look at and go, okay, well, those aren't really cool toned, but they work so good with the other shadows in here that it balances itself out. And I have talked a lot about this palette. I love this palette. And I think that they did a wonderful, wonderful job on this palette altogether. It just ended up being one of those palettes that I can look at and go, This is an exceptional palette. It's beautiful. It's bright. I don't know what it is about it other than the shadows are just that good. The colors are just that good. It's just one of those palettes. You get it on your eyes and there is nothing to complain about. And you can get so many looks out of this. You wouldn't think that looking at it that you could, but you really do. 15 pan palette, and they're big pans too. They're not little dinky pans that you're gonna hit pan on very quickly. But I think that for an all-around palette that just hits all the numbers for everybody, this palette is phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal. It's just beautiful. And I would work with this over and over again every single day if I had the chance to. If I wasn't doing this job, then I would definitely be using this palette every day, hands down. I just think it's so gorgeous. I love Sydney Grace's, all of their singles, all of their palettes, everything that they've come out with, but that palette stole my heart completely. So it is my number one cool tone palette. I hope that you guys did enjoy seeing my cool tone picks through my collection. I'm sure that there are others out there. If you guys think of any or know of any cool tone palettes that you think are really good and maybe I need to try them, I'd love to hear that from you. Thank you so much for spending a part of your day with me today. I appreciate that more than you know. Please stay safe, stay sanitized, stay healthy. All of those good things. Love you guys very much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.